welcome to our Bitcoin special. The cryptocurrency, the favorite cryptocurrency on the market, has rallied through $11,000 at one stage before easing back to just trade just below that sort of level. Over the last few days, we've seen a very strong rally for Bitcoin. So we're going to dive a bit deeper into this and what it means for traders. Now, clearly, the launch of Facebook Libra, at least the white paper that it published, has got people talking about cryptos again. We're seeing a lot of buzz around the market. Whether or not Libra is a true blockchain, a true crypto, is up for debate. It rather looks like a sort of ETF-like structure where it's pegged to various currencies and short-dated treasuries. Nonetheless, though, the market is buzzing again about cryptos, and we've seen Bitcoin rally as a result. It's already been pushing on up this year. It's up around 170% this year. We've seen what's happened is basically it's been bottoming out throughout the course of 2019, finding its base, and then is driving up higher and higher. If you look back on the five-year chart, we were up here above 19,000. This sort of level of here, around here from last year, spring of last year, is the key resistance that we're looking at. That's sort of 11,500. Now that level is, if you see, this is the weekly bar candle chart. So these are weekly spikes around that 11,500 level, 11,600. So that is a key level that we've seen tested on the upside and failed. So that is a big resistance area there. On the weekly chart, we're seeing RSI, 14 period RSI is overbought, but that's not necessarily a bad thing for Bitcoin. As we look on the daily chart, again, it's overbought on the RSI above 75, but that's not necessarily a bad thing for Bitcoin just because it signals hype and buzz. The market does move in these sort of flushes higher and is not as stable as a lot of other markets, not all other markets. We've seen the way stock market moves is likewise can be quite irrational and unstable. But the indicator is that it is slightly overbought. And we do see, as it rallies throughout the year, it does have these jumps and then it pulls back slightly before rising again. So I wouldn't be surprised if we see after this jump, a bit of a pullback, maybe a sort of bullish continuation pattern, like a flag or a pennant, where you see it just decline slightly from those levels. That sort of doji shooting star that we've got at the moment on the daily chart, that's today's candle. Now that traditionally is quite a bearish signal if that gets left as it is. We need to see that play out, though. We need to get a few more days to consider what that means. I think the way that Bitcoin moves, you do get these jumps, and that sort of bear signal that you might get usually from that sort of shooting star is not necessarily the case here. So we need to wait and see how that plays out. Again, though, I would expect maybe some kind of retracement, some kind of pullback below 11,000, which is where we're at now. Certainly to maybe the 10,000 marker, that's going to be a big support level now. I think if that 10,000 level goes, then you've got to question whether this rally has legs. And the big question is, can it reach all-time highs again? The market is, you know, is it different this time? I get traders need to look at this, see, is this any different to before? Are we going to push up to all-time highs, or can we just stay at this level? Things have changed. We've got a regulated futures contract now, which provides a certain degree of price stability and price discovery. We've certainly got more and more of the big money institutional type people are now, I think, paying attention to cryptos in a way that they maybe weren't in the past. There's a fear of missing out. They don't want to get left behind. And I think with the launch of that Libra white paper and the response from various corners of the market and regulators and so on, it's such that I think probably the big money is now doesn't want to get left behind. It knows it can't ignore blockchain any longer, which I don't think was necessarily the case before. However, nonetheless, Bitcoin's not changed. The fundamentals of this asset are unchanged from before. There's still significant doubts over its ability as a store of value, whether it can be a medium of exchange, and so on. So whilst everything's the same, there are one or two changes. So we wait to see whether this plays out as it did in the past, where we see this massive parabolic rally and then a sell-off, or if we're now seeing the start of something meaningful that will be sustained. I think you've always got to look at whenever an asset rises parabolically like this, it can't last. That doesn't mean that the level can't be held, but the gains like this are do look suspect, and whether or not it can continue to rally is a big doubt. But I would suggest that the all-time highs are now firmly in the focus of the bulls, and we could see that sort of level approach over the coming months. As I say, on the daily chart, looks overbought, but not always a bad thing for Bitcoin if it's overbought, as it signals that there's a lot of buzz and a lot of hype around this asset right now. That's all for us. Do stay tuned on X-Ray to catch more live updates throughout the week.